Hello and welcome back to the Spartan Journal, your go-to podcast for staying up to date and informed about the ever-evolving world around us. I'm your host, Shadi Khamis, and I'm thrilled to be joined by our executive editor, Alex Kaminski, along with our co-host, Liam Rhattigan. Let's dive into the sixth episode of our series where we unravel the dynamic shaping our lives today. Today, we'll be evaluating the Apple Vision Pro, expensive cities, and uptakes in sports betting. The date is February 12th, 2024, and you're listening to the Spartan Journal. Here are this week's market evaluations. The S&P 500 is down 77.47 points and 1.57% this week, while the Dow Jones Industrial Average is up 305.39 points and 0.79%. And finally, the NASDAQ is down 352.77 points and 2.26% this week.
The Russell 2000 is up 108.49 points this week and 5.60%. The MSCI International is up 3.26 points and 0.56%. While finally, the Barclays down 0.16 points and 2.14% this week. Here's your stock of the week brought to you by Stock Analysis. Sierra Health Corporation, a healthcare service company that provides health education and population wealth management. Sierra has recently received a selection as a subcontractor for a $75 billion federal contract. This looks like a great, strong future for Sierra.
Thank you, Liam. In today's episode, we're diving headfirst into the future of technology. Quite literally, with the Apple Vision Pro, a $3,500 headset, that's not just a piece of tech, but a portal into what Apple dubs spatial computing. Our guide through this digital odyssey is none other than Chris Velasco, who spent 2 weeks with this cutting-edge device. Now imagine washing dishes with a YouTube video suspended above your sink, or a virtual timer reminding you about the laundry. It sounds like something out of a cinema, doesn't it? But the intriguing part is that the Vision Pro isn't just about changing how we play or perform mundane tasks. It's about redefining our workspaces. Imagine editing spreadsheets and attending Zoom meetings in a virtual office that you can carry in your backpack. At a steep $3,500, the Vision Pro is a glimpse into an ambitious future where our physical and digital worlds blend seamlessly. Yet it begs the question, is the world ready to invest in such a pricey vision of the future? Or is this just a headset, a luxurious glimpse into what could be reserved for the few? And is this the price, a true valuation of what potential customers would purchase? And wrapping up, while Velasco may have emerged from his two-week trial more connected to his digital world, he also touched up upon a universal truth. The best technology should enhance our lives, not complicate them. Now, just related to this situation brings into mind Ready Player One, film directed by Steven Spielberg that depicts a dystopian future where everyone lives in virtual reality. But from that, it raises an important question. Does virtual reality pose more of a threat to the future of society than it offers benefits?
Thank you, Shadi, for that amazing insight on the Apple Vision Pro. I just have one question. What ethical considerations should companies like Apple take into account when developing and marketing such high-priced items like this one?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think that they should take into account definitely their potential customers for this product. The more they do this, the more business they will have for this new and exciting product.
Thank you, Shadi. This week, I'm discussing the financial impact of gambling on the Super Bowl. There is an unprecedented betting frenzy surrounding Super Bowl 58. The American Gaming Association's recent survey revealed that a staggering 67.8 million American adults, constituting 26% of the population, are anticipated to partake in betting on the big game. This year's projected total wager stands at an astounding $23.1 billion, a significant uptick from the previous year's $16 billion. The surge in betting activity coincides with the expansion of legal sports betting across the nation. Notably, around 28.7 million adults, or 11%, plan to place online bets through legal U.S. sportsbooks, underscoring the shift towards regulated markets. AGA President Bill Miller emphasized the historic significance of hosting the Super Bowl in Las Vegas for the first time, stressing the importance of consumer protection and responsible gambling practices. Former NFL player Mark Ingram II will join Miller during Super Bowl week to promote responsible betting. With bettors split between Kansas City and Chiefs and the San Francisco 49ers, the excitement surrounding the Super Bowl underscores its status as a premier sporting event with profound implications for the financial world.
That's a great article, Alex. Very interesting. Do you think this trend will continue?
I personally do not think that this trend will continue to this extent, at least due to how much popularity is based around the Super Bowl and putting down money for it. Thank you to AmericanGaming.org for this special article.
Great story, Alex. I just have one question again. Do you think this trend will continue?
I personally do not think that this trend will continue to this extent, at least due to how much popularity is based around the Super Bowl and putting down money for it.
Thank you, Alex. Now here's my article. Here's how much it costs to live in America's 10 most expensive cities. Now, I think it would be simple to just look up the cost of living in each city and determine a top 10 list in the U.S. But Business Insider took this a different route and conducted studies on families to find this out. This approach caught my eye, which is why I think it is important to learn. Economic Policy Institute decided to measure these households. These houses had two parents and two children. An EPI's family calculator measures what each family would need to make or maintain a quote-unquote good standard of living. Just to specify, the EPI spits out an average cost for families in housing, food, transportation, healthcare, childcare, taxes, and other miscellaneous expenses. Business Insiders, the one conducting the study, decided to look at families and that, and I quote, employed, live together with their children, and jointly file federal income taxes. Calculator used automatically places the healthcare at a bronze plan under the Affordable Care Act. What the calculator doesn't take into account is the childcare and how for some families that can be their biggest expense, sometimes over $2,000 a month. The other expenses are out of pocket. From the calculator used, which was EPI's, San Francisco was ranked the number one spot for the most expensive place to live, based on the evaluations of the families. The monthly total cost were an extreme $15,000 on just housing alone was $3,000. This equally compares to Stamford, Connecticut, where their housing expenses were roughly $2,600 a month. Jerome Powell stated on 60 Minutes recently that, and I quote, if you think about the basic necessities like bread and milk, prices are substantially higher than what they were before the pandemic. This is the reason most people are dissatisfied with today's somewhat good economy. To end off, I would like to mention that 6 out of the 10 most expensive metros in terms of family are within the state of California. The other cities include Boston, Cambridge, Quincy, Massachusetts, Westchester County, New York, Stamford, Norwalk, Connecticut, and Nassau, Suffolk, New York.
Thanks, Liam, for that insight. What should people focus on for their cost of living when moving to these expensive cities?
Thank you, Alex, for the question. I personally believe that a focus should be on budgeting as well as saving money well. This would be the best course option and be able to live in these cities. While it may seem out of reach for some people, with the right financial planning, it is definitely attainable. As always, a special thanks to Madison Hoff from Business Insider for providing us with this interesting study within our country.
And with that, we conclude the sixth episode of our fourth season. A huge thank you to all of you tuning in. Keep an eye out for your fellow Spartans. And as always, go green.
If you enjoyed the discussion, please like and share the podcast on Apple and Spotify. The Spartan Journal podcast is part of Michigan State University's Wealth Management Association, a student organization whose goal is to inspire the next generation of financial advisors. The Spartan Journal news team releases a newsletter every Monday morning comprised of financial literacy and the week's market updates. Feel free to follow us on social media at msuwma and check out our website at msuwma.com. Anything heard on either the MSUWMA or Spartan Journal podcasts is for educational purposes only and should not be considered as investment advice.